All right. I tell you what, technical difficulties. It's interesting when you start teaching certain things, how the enemy wants to come, how the enemy wants to stop you. So for those of you who are my intercessors, I need you guys to pray for me as I go through these teachings. We've done two segments talking about the origins of the Democratic Party. Now, when you look at, as I stated in an earlier video, you have to look at the root of a thing, and then when you go back to the root, you can trace it to looking at the fruit that's taking place right now. In the first video, we did the example of one of the founders of the Democratic Party. In fact, he was the Democratic candidate for president. Horatio Seymour was the first one that I talked about. And in this caricature from 1863, and I posted the picture, you can look at it for yourself, it shows Horatio Seymour portrayed as a rioter. And one of the quotes under that talks about, if we can't have what we want, then the people will riot. And so you look at the origins, the spiritual origins that's attached to that behavior. It goes back to the first person who opened up that portal, that spirit, for that spirit to manifest. Okay, interestingly enough, in that same picture, that same caricature, Horatio Seymour is standing with his foot on the back of a black person on the ground. Now again, these are the founders of the now what we talk about Democratic Party. This is where the Democratic Party came from. These were the individuals who established the ideology that was attached to a spirit which has perpetuated a culture which in various ways has supported that philosophy. And you still see the fruit of it today. Now, the second person that I'm going to talk about in this segment was the Tennessee general, Nathan Bedford Forrest, okay? Now, Nathan Bedford Forrest is commonly recognized as the founder of the Ku Klux Klan. He was not, now the Democratic Party did not start the Ku Klux Klan. That's not true. And if you put anything out there that says otherwise, it's going to be, you're going to get a fact check. However, Nathan Bedford Forrest is one of the original founders of the Ku Klux Klan, and he was also one of the original founders and one of the original proponents of the Democratic Party. So in the picture, which is a caricature from 1863, you see him saying, it said there was a quote that he made. And that there's a quote from something that happened in the during the war, and it's an infamous for his role in the massacre of the surrendered Union troops at Fort Pillow. He is called the Butcher Forrest. He waves a flag labeled No Quarters and fires the pistols. Extracts from reports of the Pillow Massacre are given below his picture. Now, let's look at what was the Pillow Massacre. Again, we are talking about the leaders, those individuals who founded the Democratic Party. The Democratic Party did not start the KKK. That's not true. But the one of the founders of the Democratic Party was a proponent of the Ku Klux Klan, and that's Nathan Bedford Forrest, okay, from Tennessee. Now, the Fort Pillow Massacre in Tennessee on April 12, 1864, in which some 300 African American soldiers were killed, was one of the most controversial events of the American Civil War. Though most of the Union garrison surrendered and thus should have been taken as prisoners of war, the soldiers were killed. The Confederate refusal to treat these troops as traditional prisoners of war infuriated the North and led to the Union's refusal to participate in prisoner exchange. In 1861, the Confederates constructed a military installation at the Fort Pillow site and named it for General Gideon Johnson Pillow of Tennessee. Fort Pillow overlooked the Mississippi River and was an important part of the Confederate River's defense system before it was captured by federal forces in the summer of 1862. Now, why is this important? Because the fruit is in the root. Now, these are the individuals who actually formulated the ideology that became the basis for the Democratic Party. So we've already looked at Horatio Seymour. Now we're looking at one of the second ones, which is Nathan Bedford Forrest. It goes on to say, you know, that the people who formed this ideology, there was a spiritual entity. And this is why these videos are not just for anybody can watch this, but I'm talking about people who have a spiritual conscience, who believe in God, who believe in prayer, who recognize that according to scriptures, we fight not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers and rulers of the darkness in high places. And don't get it twisted. If a principality formulated the ideology where this particular Confederate soldier, instead of taking prisoners of war, killed 300 African American soldiers, that spirit is still here today. That demonic entity is still here today. And don't get it twisted that how he kills his victims will shift from one generation to another. The same spirit that had him kill 300 African American soldiers, do you honestly think that that demonic entity left and went away? The same spirit that hated African Americans back then and was bent on our destruction is a spirit that's perpetuating the death and murder of African Americans today. And don't just think it's African Americans that get shot by police. You have to consider the 20 million African American babies that are systematically aborted with the participation and the approval of the Democratic Party that you're looking at today. You can't separate it, because the principality that led that general to kill 300 African American soldiers, which should have been taken as prisoners of war, is the same spirit that thinks it's okay to kill 20 million African American babies today. Now I'm telling it like it is, and you don't have to like these videos, but I want people to know the truth. I want African Americans in this country to know the truth, because probably the last time that our vote as a people can make a significant difference is going to be this election in November. And if you think the Democratic Party got your back, this is the Democratic Party. This is their history. This is their origins. This is their roots. And they say, oh, it's okay, we want you to have choice. And they give you the choice to kill almost 50% of the African Americans that were born in this nation since 1973 have been aborted, with the consent, the permission, and the promotion of the Democratic Party. So they say, go ahead and kill your own self so we won't have to kill you. And I'm not talking about people. I'm talking about the principalities that were at play, which came to this nation to help destroy black people. That principality wanted to destroy African Americans. It's a spirit. We wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, powers, and rulers of the darkness in high places. The same principality that was in operation behind Nathan Bedford Forrest that hated black people still hates black people. That principality, but the principality has to find someone to give him permission to destroy us. And so they have found friends in the Democratic Party that give permission for the demonic entity to continue to kill us systematically. Genocide. And they call it choice. They change the methods. They change the structure. But the same spirit. And these are the founders of the Democratic Party as you see it today. Okay? So we've covered Horatio Seymour. In this segment, we talked about Nathan Bedford Forrest. Now, Nathan Bedford Forrest is most well known for the Fort Pillow Massacre, and he is also known for his role in establishing the Ku Klux Klan. Now, the Democratic Party did not form the Ku Klux Klan. They did not. The leaders of the Democratic Party, Nathan Bedford Forrest being one of the foremost leaders, is one of the individuals that helped formulate the KKK. Okay? And so if you want to look at this, I will share the links. I'm looking at history.com. I'm looking at the Smithsonian Institute. I'm looking at Encyclopedia Britannica and a number of other sources so that you have a multiple, a variety of places. So when you go to vote in November and you're making a choice, you have to look at the whole spectrum. People are so twisted and distorted saying they just, you know, they hate this president. They hate Donald Trump. But this, when you, and then you got people going tearing down statues. This is the party, the Democratic Party, is the party that erected the statues in the first place. So when you say, go tear down the statues, you're actually tearing down statues that the party that you are supporting. I'm just saying. I'm just telling the truth. I'm putting it out there so people have a right and an opportunity to make good choices. Because if you want your vote to matter so that we get the opportunity to spread the gospel, we are in the end times. We have a short window, and all we are contending for is how the gospel is going to be spread, the difficulty with which the gospel is going to be spread, and whether we will have the support of a government that allows us to continue to spread the gospel. Because what we're going to see in subsequent videos is that the Democratic Party began to morph, it began to change, it began to evolve. And as it evolved, it began to take on characteristics that were even different from the ideologies that some of the original founders had. It began to morph and change. But it's still the same root. And the fruit is in the root. So far we've done Horatio Seymour, and then we just did Nathan Bedford Forrest. When we come back, we're going to look at two of the other founding leaders of the Democratic Party as we know it. We'll be right back after this.